नमस्कार, ऑर्श की श्रृंखला में, व्याख्यान श्रृंखला में आपका स्वागत है। और आज हमारा विषय है नेताजी और आध्यात्मिकता। जी हाँ, आध्यात्मिकता, वो आध्यात्मिकता जिसने नेताजी के मस्तिष्क को प्रभावित किया, उनके हृदय को प्रभावित किया, और किस प्रकार उन विचारकों से, उन चिंतकों से, उन धार्मिक सिद्धांतों से प्रभावित होकर नेताजी ने राष्ट्रवाद का बिगुल बजाया, उसके बारे में आपके साथ चर्चा करेंगे डॉक्टर MS पाल, कलकत्ता के जाने माने सर्जन, जिन्होंने नेताजी के ऊपर अपने जीवन का एक बड़ा हिस्सा शोध में लगाया है। आप और डॉक्टर पाल।
यूजुअली आवर कॉमन परसेप्शन अबाउट सुभाष चंद्र इज दैट ही इज जस्ट ए मिलिट्री मैन, ही इज ए हीरो, ही इज ए वॉर हीरो, ही इज नेताजी, ओनली दैट कैरेक्टर इज नोन टू अस। बट वी फेल टू सी इन द मैन a high quality philosopher, a planner, a statesman, and a spiritualist man, a warrior who is trained for years and decades, military training getting, he can be a great warrior, but that capacity in that warrior has got a limit. A medical man who is trained in a hospital for decades, acquire qualities. His strength will get a limit. But if in addition to that, he has got the spirituality, his power is tremendous. And it is beyond our imagination to what extent that man will sacrifice. The attitude of sacrifice and deep dedication magnifies the ability of a man in his works and sacrifice. This man at the bedrock is a spiritualist man, not a politician. His coming to politics is a situation compulsion, is temporary. This was for the need of the country at that time. The boy Subhas Chandra in the early days is doing performing yogas, and he is performing yoga beyond the eyes of the family persons. The family persons, parents smell it, but they cannot see it. So much secrecy is there, because to Subhas Chandra, religiosity and spirituality absolutely personal. It is not to show others. In his personal life, a very much religious man, very much spiritual man. None can see when he meditates. Only you will see him opening his mind in the latter days in his volume Indian Pilgrim, his autobiography, in late 30s. Such as he never showing his religious works, performances and spiritual performances. The man is in search of guru in his boyhood days, and when he is in Kotok, in Mahanadi, the sages are there on the banks of the river. In Calcutta, on the two sides of the Ganga, he is going there, but mysteriously going there, none can see. This is his spiritual life. And after school, his clearance of the school days, he disappeared for months. Parents are searching, senior brothers are searching. He is found in Benares, in Haridwar. He went in search of guru. Then politics to him is not the first love. First love is spirituality. And there, on returning back to Haridwar, to Benares, the chief of the Mott, Ramakrishna Mission, discovered him, he is the man of that father. And he told him, now spirituality, religion is not for you. Country is waiting for you. Go to study. A huge task of the country awaiting you. And he returned home. Then the next chapter, his graduation, ICS, resignation. And his spiritual side is first exposed, if we read, by European lady, Kitty Kutte, a German Jew, a psychoanalyst. In 30s to 37, when Subhas Chandra was in exile in Europe, this German Jew psychoanalyst came in across this man. But the first page in his writing on Subhas Chandra, this man Kitty Kutte writing, the man is spiritualist, not a politician. He has come to politics under situation compulsion to liberate his country. He is taking the help of the enemy's enemy to liberate his country. It is his compulsion. And when Subhas Chandra is telling, yes, my situation like you, you the Jews, you are being persecuted for 2000 years all over the world as refugees. And as you are tortured, my country is tortured. I have to take help from the enemy's enemy. I know, I hate this Nazis. You should leave this country. You leave this country for other European countries or to Europe. You not be able to, some people tell that he loved Nazism. Absolute lie. They do not know what is Subhas Chandra. He went there to take the help of the enemy's enemy. Germany is the enemy of Britain. He took the help of the enemy's enemy. And this is, and there in his writing, from Subhas Chandra, Kitty Kutte wants to know Tantra. Can you imagine Tantra? And he never told that he is a practitioner of Tantra. He never told. But somewhere, from somewhere, this Kitty Kutte has come to know this. And Subhas Chandra is deviating. Subhas Chandra ultimately is telling Kitty, it is absolutely personalized. This is a personal journey. This cannot be, the Tantra, the Yoga, this science cannot be communicated in words. You start your journey. This is your personal journey. This cannot be expressed in words, in books, in lectures. This is a personal journey. Rather, you have to study psychoanalysis. That will be very helpful. Psychoanalysis will make you very stronger. And about yoga, he was once the disciple of the India's great yoga guru, that is Borodacharan Mujumdar. Borodacharan Mujumdar has been described as the greatest yoga guru below the Himalayas by Aurobindo. When Aurobindo is in Pondicherry, Sadhak Aurobindo, secret. And his association with the religious persons is well known. Even his first journey leaving this country in disguise in January, middle 1941, after taking blessing from Goddess Kali of Dakshineshwar. Not before that. And even his declaration of war, forming the government, provisional government of India in Singapore, after taking blessing from, in the midnight, in the Ramakrishna mission, Singapore, in the war period, 1943, Singapore, Ramakrishna mission, there the whole night he meditated under the feet of Goddess Kali. He got the blessings and came out on the day, formed his government of, provisional government of Azadhin, and then declared the war against USA and UK. Even in 44, when under situation compulsion, he has to retreat from the Imphal Kohima front back to the Malaysia, and then to Singapore. And that retreat decision was taken in the midnight on meditation under the feet of Goddess Kali in Ramakrishna Mission in Rangoon in midnight. Then he started his return journey. And in one place, Subhas Chandra is telling, God, Lord Shiva attracts me tremendously. God Shiva is the Lord of wisdom, meditation. He attracts me. Goddess Durga Kali attracts me. Mother Kali and Durga is synonymous. They are the center of all energy in the world, in the universe. They attracts me. And then again he is telling at one time, Krishna attracts me. Because even I am a wise man, even you are a wise man, you are a man of power, that is not sufficient to defeat your enemy, to build your nation. You need to be a diplomat. And the diplomacy you have to learn from Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna attract me. In this way, in our Eastern heritage, in our mythology, in our yoga, tantras, from different godheads. Godheads are not the physical beings. These are our concepts from where we get power in different planes. Spiritual plane, physical plane, all need to be amalgamated. You cannot build yourself individually, your society and your country only through one plane. You have to bridge between in all the planes. And in this way, and one time I am telling, and he's telling, I am a Vaishnav. Vaishnav is a concept, is a feeling of love, tolerance. And this is the beginning of your journey to the horizon. Because if you love a subject, if you are devoted to a subject as a Vaishnav, then that will concentrate energy to you. Only that will, if you love a subject, if you love a country to a large extent, then that will energize you to sacrifice yourself for the country. Love is the beginning. Love is the beginning. Be Vaishnav. Love is the only a Vaishnav who loves can be a Kshatriya. Who loves the people, to protect the people, he will fight against the enemies. Only love will make you sacrifice. Without love, your inspiration of sacrifice will not come. As you love your people, love your soil, love your country, you will be compelled to sacrifice. That is Kshatriya. You will attack your enemy. This love, Vaishnav bhav, Kshatriya bhav, Shiva bhav, these are not compartmentalized. These are all continuum. These all thought processes, feelings, is a continuum. That completion will make you a complete man. A complete builder of a nation, complete builder of yourself. That is, and you have to attach yourself, that is limitless, that is horizon or limitless reservoir of energy. You attach yourself to the limitless vast ocean of energy behind. You attach yourself, you will get energy from there. And that is spirituality. Spirituality is your attachment, jivatta, you are jivatta, attaching yourself to paramatta. You, the individual, attaching yourself to the vast ocean of energy behind you, the vast ocean of wisdom, vast ocean of energy, you are attaching. From there you will get the continuous supply of your wisdom, of your energy. And you sacrifice that attachment of yourself to that vast horizon of that your consciousness or energy or wisdom, that is the spirituality. Spirituality is the attachment. It's a connection between your jivatta to the paramatta. And to him, the patriotism, love for the people of your country, is a part of your spirituality. In Indian thought process, in Indian spirituality, love for the God is one plane, love for the country is also an integral part. Without love of the country, your spirituality is not complete. Naturally, Subhas Chandra, as a spiritual man, came into politics to liberate his country. That was the essential part of building his country.